Auxilium School wishes all our dear ladies a very happy Women's Day. Last year, we celebrated the theme, I Am Generation Equality, Realizing Women's Rights. We are moving forward, realizing this, and hence, this year, we have yet another beautiful theme, that is Women in Leadership, Achieving an Equal Future in a COVID-19 World. Let us watch a very inspirational speech given by Ms. Saurabhi Gautam, IAS, who has reached the heights of leadership and has become an inspiration for every girl and boy to dream big and achieve their dreams through sheer hard work and determination.
Namaste. Today, as you see me as a package of success, when my bio says that I have cleared all the top prestigious exams and interviews of India. My friends, let me tell you not more about my successes, but more about my rejections, my failures, and my determination, my willpower that made me to get those successes. A small girl was born in our Orthodox Brahmin family. Two souls on earth were happy. Obviously, they were to be my parents. 25 years down the line, same girl, same village, and the whole family was welcoming her with garlands. Let me tell you how things changed, not only for me, but also for my parents, how all the perspectives got changed slowly, slowly, steadily, steadily. In fifth class, something good happened with me. I got 100 out of 100 in my mathematics paper. So my teacher called me and she said that, see, I have never seen anybody scoring full marks, that too in mathematics, that too in board exam. You have done this, so I think you are going to do something good in studies. That was the day when I felt appreciated and recognized, and I had given this clear message to universe that in future, all I am going to do is to be a studious girl, because with studies comes recognition. So I started to focus more on studies. But my heart, it always wanted to diversify. I wanted to do everything. I started to try my hand at painting, sketching, drawing. I started to do embroidery also. I was busy with my village priest in all the pujas and all the Ramayana ayojans and everything. Well, life was going okay. There was a problem of electricity in my village, so I had to study in kerosene lamp. I had other problems. There was no tuition. School situation was also very bad. Then the second best thing of my life happened. My 10th results came. And I again scored 100 out of 100, this time not only in mathematics, but also in science. And my percentages were good enough to place me on the state, in the state merit list. I was in news for quite a week, and the newspaper interviewer came to me, and he started to ask me questions. And at last, he asked one question. Surabhi, what do you want to become when you grow up? I was not knowing what a career is. All I was knowing that, okay, I'm good at dancing, so I can be a dancer. I can be a singer too. I can paint also, but a career. I told him, sir, I do not know. I cannot recall anything. I cannot answer this question to you. He said, come on, you have to answer this. You have got a place in merit list. Suddenly, a word flashed in my mind out of nowhere, and I said, I want to be a collector. Next day, the news came, collector banna chahti hai Surabhi. This news changed, course of everything for me. I was enjoying all that limelight, but I was not knowing how to be a collector. I went into 11th, I took mathematics. And I forgot about all these things. Well, I passed 12th and I got APJ Abdul Kalam scholarship for securing maximum marks in science stream. Thus, I came to this big city of Bhopal in this very college and took admission for Bachelor of Engineering. This decision of my parents to send me from the village to a big city for higher education was a big decision, because I was the first girl from my village to go out and study. So it was not only I who was studying here, it was the whole village along with me. If I will come back, the hopes of all other girls, the door for all other girls will close automatically. Well, the first day of my college was the worst day of my college, to be frank, because in physics, introductions were going on and everyone was standing and fluently asking, answering, giving their introduction in English, and I was freezing in my seat that when my turn will come, what am I supposed to do? What will I say? I do not know English at all. I am from a Hindi medium school. How will I introduce myself? I was stealing words from everyone's introduction, and anyhow, I jotted down the words and gave my introduction, and I thought, okay, this has passed. And he asked me, okay, tell me the definition of potential. Okay, the basic question of physics. But I had to answer this in English, and I cannot frame a sentence, a single sentence in English. So I just stood there and I kept mum. Teacher came to me and he said, Are you really, have you really completed your 12th? Have you really passed it? I'm not answering this, not because I do not know physics. It is because I do not know English. This all was going on in my mind only. I was not able to speak anything. Well, I came back to my room and I wept. I just wanted to pack my bag and go back to my village. No more higher education, nothing else. I called my parents. That day, decided that by the end of this semester, I am going to be fluent in English. Well, I took my engineering books. I jotted down all the spellings and everything. I pasted them on my wall and all my walls were colored with. And it went deep inside my subconscious mind that, you know, my dreams also were in English after that. And taught not only my college, but I taught the whole university and I got Chancellor's Scholarship. For that day, I had this belief that if you really want to achieve something, anyhow, you know, you do not have any means. Because when I wanted to improve my English, I was not able to take coaching and I was not having any English medium friend. So I was totally unarmed. But I do not know how the universe conspired and I finally was able to give a TED talk even in this platform. I completed my college when I was 20 and a half, so you need 21 years as minimum age for UPSC exam. So meanwhile, I wrote GATE exam, ISRO exam, BARC exam, SAIL exam, MPPSC exam, and after 6 months, I wrote IES exam. And my dear friends, I qualified all of them. The first call letter that I got, that was from Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Department of Atomic Energy, Mumbai. So I was very excited. Okay, I'm going to give this highly, you know, touted as the one of the most toughest interview of India. So I was about to appear in that interview. I consulted some of my seniors about how it can be, how should I prepare for it. All I got was negative feedback. I appeared in interview. So I qualified that interview and I became a nuclear scientist. Well, I wrote IES exam meanwhile. After 1 year, the result came. And I was AIR1, not from any IIT, not from any NIT. I was from UIT and I topped that. I was the first lady in India to top engineering service exam. So finally, after becoming a Sarkari officer, I resigned from BARC and I joined Indian Railways through engineering service, and I went to Secunderabad for railways training. I was getting salary, there is no financial problem. You know, I was getting respect from society, so I did not to study anymore, no hard work, so all party was waiting for me. And I was very excited, okay, life is now going to be a smooth ride, no more hard work, no more sacrifices and all, I have done enough. Why am I not enjoying all this? Was this struggle was only for a Sarkari job or a good salary, or was this was something for something else also? I really recalled and I read this interview again and I decided to prepare for civil service examination. Well, this examination, I want to say, is one of the toughest exam of not only India but of world, and mostly it takes 4-5 attempts for them. And I was doing the job of railways, was deciding to prepare for this exam. I was hardly getting 3 or 4 hours from my training to prepare for this exam. I could not take leave in training also. Things I decided to go ahead and I started my preparation. I was mostly on train roaming so I bought a tab and I downloaded all the things. So I started reading online. And sometime I felt frustrated. I felt like giving up. Again, I called my mom. She was a continuous mentor for me. Even after becoming a Sarkari officer, I have to do again all these things. Life is so miserable for me. I was never enjoying when I was a child. And today also when I'm an officer, I'm not enjoying. I'm only doing studies and I don't know where it is going to lead. Am I going to qualify it or not? I'm not sure, but still I'm again studying all that. See, you are 23. When I was 23, so I had all these problems, but I never complained. You, on the other hand, do not have any social responsibility, familial responsibility. All you have is your dream. All you want is to prove for yourself, because for others you have already proved. You are saying life is difficult at you. You need to change your lenses, beta. That day, I stopped complaining mostly, at least with her. And I was totally on a mission mode. The more I struggled, more strong I became. And finally, I got All India Rank 50 in this coveted exam, civil services examination. To summarize, truly tell my story. And I also want to convey these words to you also. There is no substitute of hard work and there is no shortcut to success. Thank you. Thanks for being such a patient and such a good audience.
Dear young ladies, our life has been given to us to create legacies. Dream daily about the legacy you want to be and strive hard, because you are a gateway to the next generation. We offer this prayer that our women all over the world have the strength and courage to fight adversities and succeed. Heavenly Father, we lift up the young women of the nation before you. guide and direct their ways. They need you. Help them to seek righteousness and to yearn for you and you alone. Lead them down the path of righteousness so they can become outstanding role models and leaders to the younger generation. Once again, we wish you a very happy Women's Day.